I believe the CIA was using the Jamaican Labor Party as its instrument in the entire campaign against the Michael Manley government. I'd say most of the violence was coming from the Jamaica Labor Party side, and behind them was the CIA in terms of getting the weapons in and getting the money in with all the propaganda guidance, because there was a steady stream, a continuous campaign of propaganda against the Manley government. The weapons, there was no problem that with getting weapons in, because the ganja smuggling was a perfect route for bringing weapons back into Jamaica from the United States.
While local politicians benefited from outside assistance, Bob Marley condemned them in his songs.
The CIA would look upon the radical political content of reggae music as dangerous, because it would help to create a consciousness among poor people, among the great majority of Jamaicans. And of course, naturally, the climate was created for an attempt on Bob Marley's life. The purpose of all those activities of violence and armed robbery and murder, coupled with the propaganda campaigns calling for the overthrow of the Manley government, naturally created a situation of terror, really, of tension, of uncertainty, of doubt, and fear. This was the purpose